Hi everybody, my name is Matt Elliott and I'm here at Guaranty RV Supercenters today to show you an exciting new vehicle from Winnebago. This is a Class B motorhome. It's called the Winnebago Boldt, and just so you know, that's spelled with a D, B-O-L-D-T, and it's not B-O-L-T if you're trying to look it up. And this is a great vehicle because, first of all, this happens to be the four-wheel drive version of it. And they have two really unique floor plans. This particular one is called the 70BL, and it's a fantastic rig on many levels. The first thing is that this is four-wheel drive. The second thing is it's a Mercedes-Benz. And the third thing is this has Winnebago's new Pure 3 electrical system, which includes 800 amp hours of lithium ion battery power and a 3 kilowatt inverter and a lot of other technologies that really make this a useful vehicle. Let's take a look inside. It's such a cool rig. One thing I didn't show you, this is a power door. So in the past, the Mercedes has been a manual door you slide. This one here, you push a button, it opens right up. Now, from a design standpoint, this one's different than most of the camper vans you look at, because most camper vans are designed with a power sofa that's across the back, and that gives you more seatbelt positions in the rear, but it interferes with the passage of the door. So if you have long things you want to put in here, like surfboards or snow skis, this gives you a lot better access to the back. And it's not really intended for people to travel back here, although there are a couple of seat belts if you want to secure some folks. These two twin beds make really nice big bedding areas that these back cushions can be removed, or they can be set into the center to make it into a queen bed. So you have that choice. And of course, there's some storage underneath in some of these cabinet areas, and there's a ton of overhead storage. Now, this vehicle is interesting too, because some people aren't comfortable with the long Mercedes chassis. There's actually three sizes. This is the middle one. So not a 24 footer, but a 23 footer. A 22.7 if you want to get real persnickety about it. Lots of storage with adjustable shelving here. And as you look back here, you've got these huge overhead storage compartments with hidden hinges. And this has a beautiful laminate, glossy finish interior. This is nice stuff because you can wipe this down. By the way, with Winnebago, they manufacture most of everything that goes into their vehicles, including their cabinets. If you ever need to get a part replaced, these guys can do it for you, even if it's been out of production for a while. Take a look here in this Boldt, and you can see that there's a nice bathroom right there. And it's all one piece, so you can get it wet, it's gonna dry off, it's not gonna be a problem. Another thing that's kinda neat about this one is this has an option of dual pane plexiglass windows. And that's nice because they're a lot warmer, there's a lot less heat transfer and condensation. Now, as we look at the galley here, something you don't usually see in a camper van is a lot of counter space. This has great counter space. It's got a nice big deep sink with a solid surface countertop. It's pretty. And then it's got the induction cooktop. Now, this is something you're going to find on things that do have onboard inverter systems, and this certainly has the ability to operate off the grid, and you can turn on your air conditioner, your induction cooktop, and all of the components in here work just off batteries. You don't have to be plugged in, you don't have to have anything running. It's just got such an ample supply of power. It's also got a lot of solar power, so this really has the ability to be what I call a rolling power plant. Now, another thing that's really nice about this coach inside is this uses the Truma combi heating system. And what that does for you, first of all, is it's a lot quieter. It's not really noisy like a forced air furnace is. And it does a nice job of really heating the coach in an ambient way. It uses heated glycol tubes in the floor, so you get kind of a nice floor heat and heat rises up. And it can also use the system to heat the water. What's really special about it is I can heat water and do my furnace stuff in here with electricity or propane, or I can use them both at the same time if I'm in a hurry. So this is just a really, really nice feature to have. If we come over here, hear people talk about these lithium ion systems. They're not complex. This one's the simplest of all. All you have to do is push the button and it turns on. There's a little gauge here that shows exactly how much power you have in your battery system, so you can get an idea what you're doing. And this one's quite full. It would last a long, long time. And of course, every time you drive it, it recharges. The solar constantly recharges. And you can hook it up to shore power. So there's a lot of ways to get power into this rig. This also has a high output alternator, so it recharges off the engine battery, very, very fast. Okay, so as we look at the front here, you can see that we've got seating, and there's seat belts for a person here, and then of course you're seating up here. These seats can swivel, so this whole area turns into a nice living space. And as a vehicle, this is the newest version of the Mercedes van. So there's a lot of things to look at in here. First of all, this has a whole bunch of the new safety technologies that you're seeing on their cars. So this has adaptive cruise control, and it has lane alert systems, and it has all kinds of things to prevent you from having a collision. The windshield wipers will work automatically. There's a whole spectrum of stuff. I really can't tell you all about it right now. There's so many things to talk about. It's also got a new way of shifting the four-wheel drive and the transmission here. So you want to definitely take a look at these when you get into one, because it operates a little differently than what you're used to. But it's simple, it's easy, and very effective. They also have a great intuitive screen here with a navigation system, and you can even talk to your car. It'll do just about everything that you can imagine in terms of connectivity with your cell phones and control. And you can also do all these controls from your steering wheel, so you no longer have to be down here fiddling around, risking your safety while you're trying to pay attention to your equipment instead of paying attention to the road. Okay, let's take a quick look at the exterior. There we go. Oh, something else I wanted you to see on this. This has the best screens for when the doors open, you can screen this all off. What you can see here, these screens are installed and they zip down like this. And when you want to go in and out, you can leave the zippers connected and you can just walk out through this magnetic strip, and then it closes itself right back up. Really nicely designed. Some of the rigs have these accordion screens that go across here, and they're hard to operate. This is much, much better. Okay, now, one of the things you'll notice right off the bat in the front is that this has a whole new appearance. They've redesigned the front end. It's a little more aerodynamic. It's got the new headlights with the LED highbrows on it, and they're just really, really nice. And up here, we see a really nice aerodynamic design. Now, one of the beauties about getting a camper van instead of a traditional motorhome, it's all steel, it's all wind tunnel design, and so this vehicle isn't going to have the leaks and squeaks and rattles that you might encounter after a few years in a typical RV. This is very solid state. Now, if you look at down here at the wheels, you're going to see that we have all aluminum wheels, and also that this has quite a bit of ground clearance. So the wheel and tire package that are on here set it up. The four-wheel drive system sets it up. So if you're going into rough roads and you like to go skiing and do stuff like that, this rig is designed a little bit better for that. Okay, now up here, you can see you have a power awning. And this is a dynamite awning. It comes way out here. You just push a button, and it's even got a wind sensor. So if the wind comes up, it can retract itself before it gets damaged by, you know, wind and stuff. Also, it's nice to notice that this has a beautiful monochromatic exterior. The bolts are not covered with a lot of crazy looking stripes, so you can park them in your driveway. They just look like a regular van, and you know, certainly not going to draw attention to your house when they're parked in front. They're not all gaudy and flashy. If you look back here, it's a really, really neat feature on this rig is that this has a rear ladder. And that ladder is removable. I can actually take it off and move it around the vehicle on this side and have access to a roof rack. Now, the beauty of this is that I can do a lot of different things. I can use the roof for kayaks. I can put storage compartments up there. I can pretty much haul whatever I want on top of my vehicle. And that's something that we've never been able to do in camper vans until the advent of this roof rack system. Also, we see we've got a tow hitch back here, and this works dynamite. It's already wired. This will pull up to 5,000 pounds. So if you're pulling a nice big boat or anything you want, this is a great rig to have with that. This is a good way to see sort of what I was talking about, being able to access this back area. And I want to just also point out, we also have that screen system here too. So when you're camping in this one, you can open all the doors, let all the fresh air and sunshine in, and keep the bugs out. You can even sleep in it that way. It's a dynamite setup. This whole thing is so well designed, and there's some new features too that I haven't pointed out yet. And that is that we have these tracks built into the vehicle, and these are throughout the vehicle. That's so we can attach things. So if you have a tablet you want to display or anything like that, it works great. Okay. Now, as you come down this way, you're going to notice that there's really not a lot sticking out on the side of this rig. Most motorhomes have a lot of doors and compartments and hatches. This just doesn't have that. This is very, very streamlined, and it doesn't look like a motorhome. I guess that's the big deal. So the first thing to realize about a Boldt is you could drive it anywhere and you don't have to hook to a campsite. You'll have the power to run your air conditioner and 110 appliances all you want. Second thing to realize, it's a Mercedes diesel. This will get very, very good gas mileage and be extremely reliable for many, many, many years. That's why people buy Mercedes. Most of these vans actually go to the commercial industry. So I hope you enjoyed this short walkthrough on the Winnebago Boldt. If you have any questions, I'd be more than happy to talk to you in person, or you can give me a call. My name's Matt Elliott, and you can reach me at 541-954-8495. You have a great day.